We're given a line plot and asked to create a second line plot with 8 data values that has a mean that is 1 mean absolute deviation larger than the mean of the given data and has the same mean absolute deviation. So from the given line plot, notice how the data values are 121, 222s, 123, and 428s. Now let's review how we find the mean absolute deviation. The mean absolute deviation of a set of data is the average distance between each data value and the mean. And here are the steps to find the mean absolute deviation. Step 1, we find the mean. Step 2, we find the difference between each data value and the mean. Step 3, we take the absolute value of each difference. And then step 4, we find the mean of these differences. So for step 1, we need to find the mean of the given data. So we need to add all these data values up. And the sum of these data values is 200. Which means the mean of the given data is going to be equal to 200 divided by the number of data values, which is 8. So 200 divided by 8. We first ask how many 8's in 20, which is 2. 2 times 8 is 16. Subtract. This difference is 4. Bring down the 0. Ask how many 8's are in 40, which is 5. 5 times 8 is equal to 40. Notice how this difference is 0, so we don't have a remainder. The mean of the given data is exactly 25. Now the next step is to find the difference between each data value and the mean. So let's do that. So the first difference is going to be 21 minus 25, which equals negative 4. Then we'd have 22 minus 25, which equals negative 3. Here we have the same difference. Here we'd have 23 minus 25, which equals negative 2. Then we have 4 differences of 28 minus 25, which is 3. Step 3, we find the absolute value of each difference. So here we'd have the absolute value of negative 4, which is 4. Here we have the absolute value of negative 3, which is 3. And the same here. The absolute value of negative 2 is 2. And then we have the absolute value of 3, which is 3, a total of 4 times. Our last step to find the mean absolute deviation is to find the mean of these differences. So the next step is to find the sum, and then again we'll divide by 8 because there are 8 values. So we have 10 plus 5, that's 15, plus 9, that's 24. So 24 divided by 8 is equal to 3, which tells us the mean absolute deviation equals 3. Now let's go back to our directions one more time. We want to create a second line plot with 8 data values that has a mean that is 1 mean absolute deviation larger than the mean of the given data and has the same mean absolute deviation. So for our second line plot, we want the mean to be 1 mean absolute deviation larger than the mean of the given data. So the mean would be 25 plus 1 times 3, which equals 28. So we want the new mean to be 28, but we still want the mean absolute deviation to be equal to 3, which again is the average distance between each data value and the mean. So looking at our new number line, we want the mean to be 28, which would be here. We want the mean absolute deviation to be 3, which means the average distance from the data values from 28 needs to be 3. Well, if we only had 2 data values, notice how if we put in 1 data value 3 units above the mean here at 31 and 3 units below the mean here at 25, these 2 data values would have a mean of 28, and notice how their distance from the mean is 3 units, which means the mean absolute deviation would be 3. So while there are many possible solutions to this question, probably the most easiest and obvious solution would be to have 4 data values of 25 and 4 data values of 31. Here we can easily see the mean is going to be 28, and because all the data values have a distance of 3 units to the mean, the mean absolute deviation would be 3. I hope you found this helpful.